Meadow, Agawam, Feeding Hills, Springfield, Southwick, as well as Enfield and Granby, Connecticut, visit us on the web at westfieldbank.org.
Support for Community Radio on WSKB is provided by Betts Plumbing and Heating Supply Company, an independent, family-owned wholesaler serving Westfield for over 50 years, specializing in plumbing, heating, and industrial piping supplies. On the web at BettsPlumbing.com or at 14 Coleman Avenue in Westfield.
Listen to me, Michael Buster McMahon, Mondays 8 to 10 a.m. to learn the stories behind your favorite songs. Or don't. I'm not the boss of you.
Community Radio.
89.5 WSKB.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 and 89.5 FM WSKB Westfield. good morning, and welcome to Superintendent Spotlight with Zap and Chris, broadcasting live from beautiful Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, where the outside temperature appears to be 16 degrees, Mr. Zaporowski. But yeah, in here, nice and toasty, it's 72.
Yep.
Right, Pete?
Yep. Well, it's supposed to be 16 degrees this time of year.
Absolutely.
We're going to get spoiled this weekend, though.
It's going to be 60, I think, on Saturday.
What? That's what they say.
And
yeah,
Sunday, too. That's crazy.
Really?
Yeah.
That's good, though. We need these melts so we don't get flooded in the spring.
Exactly.
Absolutely. Well, yeah. Happy New Year to everybody.
Happy New Year.
This is our first show of 2020 there.
It is. And my first, because I wasn't here for your last show you did with Denise and Susan.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I don't think you've been on the air in a while.
I was on the show before that. I was on the show.
The band show.
I was on
with
Corey Bruno, and the choir was.
Yeah, but that was like a month ago.
Yeah, it's been a month.
Mm. Wow.
We didn't have a show.
We didn't have a show last week. That's right.
So today, though, right?
Yeah.
We're talking everything Franklin Avenue.
All right.
And we have Principal Chris Tolpa with us. And why don't you let us know who you brought?
Well, this morning I am fortunate enough to bring Kelly Brown from the Boys and Girls Club and Lindsay Ayer, second grade teacher at Franklin Avenue Extraordinaire.
Excellent. Tell us a little bit about Franklin Ave before we get what's changed, what's happening over there. Give us a quick rundown. I know that Monday night at school committee, they voted to move forward on the feasibility study about that project. So
they did.
Anyone who's been paying attention to that, we've completed the eligibility period. We are now in the feasibility period to determine what we're going to do with that area. And really, I want to emphasize to folks that it runs the full gamut. It could be a rehabilitation expansion. It could be a knockdown, completely new building.
Right.
But that's what this period does. So I think it's great that the building committee has been established. You are on it.
I saw that, and I'm really impressed with the diversity of that.
Absolutely.
We have a lot of good voices from different constituencies.
Absolutely.
Good.
And I want to note for folks to know, too, we're having our first meeting soon. I believe it's the 13th.
Monday
at 5 o'clock.
Yep.
And that's the first meeting, and those that gets posted. It's, you know, it's like a public open meeting law.
Right.
So we follow all of that. But for anyone who wasn't, you know, if they say, hey, I wanted to be on that building committee, there could only be a certain number of members.
Correct.
And some of those positions are mandated. But we are going to have some subcommittees too. So
right.
I think that's important. So if people are interested, you know, you can reach out to my office, Mr. Rogers' office, or
yeah, and I'll let the
Chris's
teachers know
office.
that there's going to be some specific expertise that we're going to need.
Right.
And so those people are going to be needed.
Right.
So they may
it's
be
not
asked.
That you can't be a part of it. It's
right.
Just again, there's only certain people that can be on the committee, and that's like the school committee people,
right.
The mayor and superintendent.
Right.
Principal.
Yeah, yeah, you know, I think you are needed. Yeah.
I am. But so that's new. So how many students do you have?
Today we have about 216.
216. And of course, for anyone who doesn't know, K-4.
Yeah, we are K-4. We have the most curious and loving children that you could ask for. We are the heart of Westfields. Heart
I saw
is,
the t-shirts.
Yes.
I posted that, yeah.
You know, I was going to wait, but I do have one for you.
Oh, good.
Yes, yes. But
perfect.
Our motto is heart. It stands for, H is for honor, E is for effort, A is for attitude, which we really stress, R is for responsibility, and T, if you listen to all of our students, that's the biggest one that gets teamwork.
Yeah.
And we try to incorporate that every single day into all that we do, including our morning meetings. If somebody has a problem, they make a mistake, come down to my office. We talk about which part of heart did you break.
Right.
So sometimes it's
the
like
heart is part of the PBIS piece. Is that or is it separate?
It is totally part of the PBIS initiative.
We do talk about that regularly when
Absolutely.
We have our principals on. So I just want to make that point.
Yeah. There. Yeah. So.
But I saw you had an assembly, and all the kids had their little.
We gave
nice.
Every student and every staff member and some of our volunteers a heart shirt right
nice.
Before the holidays. And they're going to wear it every time we have our heart raffle.
That's terrific.
It's great. And they were really excited. And some of them wear it, you know, almost every day. And
right. Well, that's not a bad thing.
No,
I mean, they're showing their school pride.
Exactly.
So what do you want to talk about first?
I really want to start with Kelly Brown because she and the boys.
Good morning, Kelly.
Hi, Kelly.
Good morning.
Have just been instrumental in providing some really wonderful support for our families at Franklin Avenue from grades 3 and 4.
All right, Kelly, what do we got?
So we were fortunate enough to be able to secure a 21st century grant through the Department of Education through the state of Massachusetts.
Right.
Long process. Thank you to all of you who participated because it was definitely a collaborative effort.
Thank you.
having the 21st century program at the club has just been a great addition to what we have down there. The way that the program works is we have 30 students from Franklin Avenue, as Ms. Tolpa said, in third and fourth grade that come down every day. And they have their own space in the club. We were lucky enough to squeeze them. I use that term very loosely. For those of you who know where we're looking to do a little bit of an expansion there too, this is one of the reasons. But they do have their own classroom, but the great part is that they get to utilize all portions of the club as well. So the thing that we're finding, and again with the help of Ms. Tolpa, was what do these kids need most after school? And together, collaboratively, we came up with the fact that they need their own place. They need the opportunity to have, you know, an outdoor field and things to be able to do outside buildings instead of just inside, because a lot of these kids are in housing and they just don't have grass.
Right. Yeah.
Simple things. Swimming.
A lot of our kids spend far too much time inside.
Exactly. Yes. Yeah. Exactly.
Adults, so, too, just saying.
Yep. Absolutely. Everyone, yeah. Period.
Yep. Yeah. Right. So it does both, because it gets the adults in the club and the kids outside,
right.
You know.
That's right.
But we were fortunate enough to hire Pat Mahoney, who was formerly from the now intermediate school as the health teacher.
Right.
Westfield Intermediate.
There you go. And our staff as well. We have some certified teachers who have just newly become certified that are a part of the program. And it's just working out great. And to see those kids get off that bus every day and run to that room and come in with a smile and leave with a smile, and the parents too. It's really been a great collaboration.
Awesome.
Absolutely. Yeah. And the structure that you provide for them, it's not just come in and, you know, here's the club.
Right.
There's time to do homework.
Yep.
There's time to explore different things. A lot of the kids, digital photography was a big one. You know, if you don't have a camera and you've never done digital photography, it's pretty cool being able to see your own photographs and being able to meld
I think
them.
We're in the shop where that actually occurs.
I think so. Yeah. So taking that, I mean, you have aspiring people that come and attend the tech academy, you know? So
absolutely.
Yeah.
And of course, we have students behind the cameras here even doing live broadcasting now. So
that's absolutely exactly
this is pretty great. Yeah. Thank you, students. You're doing a great job.
They are doing a great job.
They really are.
And Sam comes to the Boys and Girls Club, so he knows firsthand what it's like down there.
Yeah.
We also have, which is really cool, we just received some new STEM activity kits, and I don't know if the kids have shared this with you or not, but they actually built an artificial knee the other day with one of the kits. Which was a great STEM activity. Yeah.
Photos?
Started, yep, photos? We have photos. Yep.
Okay.
It started with a story about a boy who hurt his leg and wanted to continue running, and what was he going to be able to do, and the kids actually had to do the story and then physically put the knee together. So it was really cool, and we had Steve Dowd, who works during the summer program for you guys, he came down and he'll be doing the 6-week program with our kids. So it's just great opportunities for the kids. But like I said, even the simple things like swimming and playing in the games room and being able to go up to the gym, I have to be honest, they really have left the electronic portion of it alone and are really enjoying the ability to just
interact with one another.
Exactly.
And it builds such a community back at Franklin too, because they become more like brothers and sisters sometimes, where there's a little, you know, but they, you know, you can just tell that there's a bond that has been formed and forged. And you know, when they walk out of the building onto the bus, and they're all ready to go.
Well, I may have missed it. How many students are we talking about?
30.
30.
Right.
Huh? That's beautiful.
Yeah.
That's
and the families are very appreciative. This is all free.
Well, and that was a $140,000 grant.
Correct.
Three-year grant. 3 years.
Yep.
Right. So
yep.
The funding, you can use it over, obviously, the 3 years period.
Yep.
So
you get 104. Well, you have to use your $140,000 a year. So,
or you use it or lose it. You know, it's one of those.
Right.
You know,
right. Sure. The state is great, but they have that retractable.
Yes, they do.
You know, but which is working out great for us, because as Ms. Tolpa just said, this program is 150% free.
Yes.
And this will continue into the summer. So we will also offer these children 4 weeks of summer camp at no additional cost to families.
Which also includes the food. You know, they get a snack and dinner every night at the Boys and Girls Club.
Wow. Wow.
Yep.
So run me through
yeah,
a day of a child that so they leave Franklin. Yep.
Correct.
They go to the Boys and Girls Club. Kelly, yep. Lead me through a day.
So they check in into their classroom. Okay. They have their own cubby area. So like I said, they have their own space to be able to go into. They check in with Miss Mahoney and the other teachers. And every week there's a curriculum. So on Mondays it may be digital arts in the computer lab, which is a programmed classroom. So they're learning while they're in the environment.
That's great.
And then they have the opportunity to participate in, we have Echo Warriors that takes place in the education room, learning about the environment, and a lot of the kids really like that. They have the opportunity to go into the art studio if their creativity needs to explode. And then every night at 5:30, they come back together as a group and they have dinner together in their classroom. And then from 6 to 6:30, they get the minors room, which is the game room, which is another great opportunity. I mean, you know, a lot of people that see the games room, see the chaos. We call it organized chaos. And
sure,
they don't understand what that room teaches kids. It teaches them patience. It teaches them teamwork. It teaches them to look out for each other.
Sportsmanship.
It really does. It really does a lot for them. And it's a great way for the kids to kind of wind down after a long day. Parents pick up. You know, it's always, thank you. We can just go home and be a family because I know their homework's done. They're already fed. So now we can just have some real quality family time.
That's fabulous.
Yep.
Yeah. That's fabulous.
Yep.
Absolutely. So for the next few years with the grant, is there an expansion possibility, or is it because these 30 now are, what grades are they in?
They're
grades,
third and fourth.
Yeah, third and fourth.
So some of them will be going on to fifth.
Yep.
Correct.
So how are you replacing?
Correct. Yes. So when our second graders come up, there will be spots available when they're third graders to take the remaining spots.
All right. Okay. Perfect.
Yeah.
Cool. All right. Well, I think we should, sounds like a good time to take a break.
Perfect
right
time.
There. It is. You're listening to WSKB 89.5 FM Superintendent Spotlight. It's 9:03. We'll be back in a couple minutes. Thank you.
see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you have to do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. Now ain't it good to know that you've got a friend when people can be so cold? They'll hurt you, yes, and desert you, and take your soul if you let them. Oh, but don't you let them. You just call out my
Support for Community Radio on WSKB is provided by Betts Plumbing and Heating Supply Company, an independent, family-owned wholesaler serving Westfield for over 50 years, specializing in plumbing, heating, and industrial piping supplies. On the web at BettsPlumbing.com or at 14 Coleman Avenue in Westfield.
Listen to me, Michael Buster McMahon, Mondays 8 to 10 a.m. to learn the stories behind your favorite songs. Or don't. I'm not the boss of you.
Community Radio.
89.5 WSKB.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 and 89.5 FM WSKB Westfield.
Hey, welcome back to Superintendent Spotlight, and just a couple of quick announcements for you. June, you know where my mind is. I'm looking outside at a mound of snow. Yeah. Although I like that, I like this background, Pete. This is great.
Yeah, this background's cool.
It makes us look like we're newsy, but
CNN,
it's okay.
CNN or something.
Yeah, it's a standard ESPN. Standard like news set background.
It is. We're official.
Sort of. Yeah, sort of.
I like the fact that Kenny put a table skirt. So you don't see the cables much anymore.
Or your feet.
Yeah, the feet, yeah.
So people can't see how fidgety I am because I can't stay still for 2 seconds.
On the wide shot, yeah.
So my feet are like I'm dancing under the table over here. But because Kelly's here too, so January 16th from 6 to 7:30 at the Boys and Girls Club of Greater Westfield, we will be having our Countdown to Kindergarten event. Yeah. That's typically not until April.
We usually wait till spring, and we're doing it really early.
We want it early because we hope that, and that's my plea is for folks, if you know you have someone registering as a kindergarten student in Westfield schools next year, it helps us if we know as soon as possible because it helps us with counts and how many teachers we need and so on. And it amazes me the last few years, it seems like we have large enrollment that last week of August, which really throws us off.
It does. And we try to tell people too all the time because it's an old misconception that we're closed during the summer.
We are not.
Schools are not closed during the summer.
And you can
you can
begin the registration process online. Just go right to webpage. It says online registration. Click on that
link.
Absolutely. And it's easier than ever.
Well, and when you go to the Boys and Girls Club for our Countdown to Kindergarten.
And you're there.
Yeah.
All the principals are there.
Yeah. But we have people that are there to help you go through the registration process
there,
to get you start. I just want to put a plug in you know, when you go, you're going to learn about dates. And for Franklin Avenue, our kindergarten screening date is going to be May 28th.
Earlier than usual.
We're going to tell you what screening's about, because every parent wonders, wow, what happens when my child goes into that room? And, you know, we'll let you know what they need to know. Right. We have our kindergarten play date already set up for August 27th of next year.
Wow. Because the calendar was finally finalized.
Because the calendar. And then we have our kindergarten orientation that it's tentative right now. But, I mean, so these are some great things that you can already plan for if you come, and you can meet kindergarten teachers, meet principals, no bus routes. It's a great opportunity.
Well, children are actually welcome to attend the event as well. And so what's nice is families can get information about local before and after school programs, such as the Boys and Girls Club, right?
Yep.
They'll also get to learn about the play dates that will take place over the summer at the elementary schools so that new students can meet their classmates.
Yep.
They'll learn about school meals, sample menus. They can get any transportation questions answered. And as you mentioned, there will be assistance to help parents register their child. So this is a good thing. I hope that you're able to attend. If you have any questions, please contact Paula Hebert Pike at 413-568-5282. Again, for more information about this event. But again, I encourage you, please register as soon as possible.
Oh, absolutely.
It helps us in a lot of ways. And then, you know, it helps us keep our class size down too for kindergarten, because if you get 100 kids registering that last week of August, for example, well, we
puts
haven't
us
planned
in a little
for
bit of a bind.
We haven't planned.
We have 48 in Franklin right now in kindergarten classes.
Right.
So you know, and that.
But
was
you
a lot
didn't in August. And that's
at the beginning of August, we didn't.
No,
we didn't.
And by that point, our budget plan has already happened. So
correct.
You can only shift so much. So
correct.
Countdown to kindergarten is something else, and I just want to mention our Special Education Parent Advisory Council, because there is no January meeting, but their next meeting is on February 6th, which is Let's Learn About Summer. So can you tell where people's minds are going already? I think, you know, it's maybe we've had enough of winter already.
Well, I was at Westfield Intermediate for the full day the other day, you know, during walkthroughs, and one of the staff came up to me and said, "Oh, Mr. Rogers, you ready for summer school yet?" And I said, "No, but thank you for reminding me that we have to start getting that ball rolling."
Yeah, we're actually talking about it next Monday.
Yeah, we're talking about it on Monday. Oh,
so
goodness.
It's amazing how fast the year is going by.
It is.
So Kelly, thank you for letting us use the space at the Boys and Girls Club, by the way.
No worries. And just to add a little bit to that, too, we will have our buses out, which doesn't seem like a big deal. But if your child's getting on a school bus for the first time,
absolutely.
That first day, we've noticed that in years past, we put them on the bus and it just takes a little bit of that anxiety out. So it's the little things that are going to happen that night too. So it is really important.
I would encourage anyone who has a kindergartner to please, or a potential kindergartner to please come to that event for those reasons.
Yep.
And of course, they can sign up for before and after school programs at the Boys and Girls Club.
Yep. Too, so. Yeah. And we will have the YMCA there as well.
Yep. Right.
And I just want to strongly encourage that you park at the middle school parking lot
or
Amelia Park parking lot.
Great call, Kelly.
Because there is going to be very limited parking at the Boys and Girls
Club. Well, and I've been the last 2 years, it's been packed.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
And I imagine hopefully this year, we're really promoting it, so hopefully it's more packed.
Yep.
All right, back to Principal Topa. We're talking about Franklin Avenue Elementary School today. And you wanted to lead us right into STEM next, right?
I did, yeah.
And what does STEM stand for?
Science, technology, engineering, and math.
There you go.
And,
perfect.
You know, there's a big push for it. And especially when it comes to getting females into the realm of STEM, because there's other research out there says there's a disproportionate amount of men to women when it comes to those fields. So one of the things that we have taken on is a grant from Project Lead the Way.
Right. Now you got a grant there. The middle school got one, and so did Westfield High School.
Correct.
So almost $100,000 for all three.
Right. And so what's the difference between the high school, the middle school, and the elementary is that the high school has specific tracks.
Right.
So they have an engineering track, let's just say. At the middle school, they have classes. At the elementary level, they have what's called modules, and there are 10-hour modules. And so they are aligned to the state standards.
Right.
They will reach a multitude of different things, including our technology standards. But what has to happen first is this is what we had the grant for. We sent teachers to be trained at Worcester Polytechnical Institute
over last summer. Yeah.
Correct.
So again, I just want to reiterate for folks who think that every teacher takes every summer off.
Oh, no.
That is not the case.
No, not at all.
But
not
that is all. a uh,
Education is
a 12-month
profession.
It really is. Emphasizing, we're not closed in summer.
We are not closed in July and August.
Correct. Okay. So Project Lead the Way, four teachers, one in kindergarten, first, second, and third, went to become trained. And this fall, we've spent preparing to launch those modules. And the word launch is significant because that is what the elementary program is called. It's called Launch. And so where the kindergarten, who just started in January, are going to be looking at pushes and pulls. And one of the activities that they did was a tug of war. Some kids had never played tug of war, but they talked about the pushes and pulls. They also did a scavenger hunt in the classroom about what can be pushed and what can be pulled. And after talking to Ms. Nielsen, the kindergarten teacher, she was like, you know, I didn't even think that the water fountain can be pushed, you know, my screen can be pulled. So they discovered, you know, it was inquiry-based learning.
Nice.
Yeah. And each module has a certain set of piece of literacy to it.
Are the kids enjoying it? That's what I...
Immensely. Yeah. In fact, we, instead of having a half hour of science every day or every other day,
right,
we have combined it to be a longer block on a Friday. So she calls it Science Friday. So it's because of all the materials and picking up and clean, with kindergartners, to have that hour and a half block
is huge.
And so while her students are learning about science, the other kindergarten's learning about social studies,
right,
and then they will flip-flop.
Very nice.
Yeah, so Ms. Nielsen will get to learn the module even more by teaching it twice.
But it was interesting, too, because during STEM Week, which we had in October, which, by the way, it was a huge hit here.
Massive success.
I know we didn't survey your students, but we did survey the intermediate and middle school students, and 89% of them were overly, I mean, they just were so thrilled with STEM Week and wished that school could be like
that
all the time.
Can we do like this all the time?
All the time.
Same as summer school.
Yeah. Because you're doing all hands-on projects.
Right. Mm-hmm.
But the reason I'm bringing that up is because you brought a class of students to Westfield State University that day about STEM.
Correct.
And Lieutenant Governor Karen Polito was there. And she was pushing women in STEM.
Absolutely.
And I think, you know, so it's not just, it's coming from multiple areas.
Right.
And I think it's really important. And I get excited, you know, as the former principal here, but when you see non-traditional like students, you know, because there are non-trad, what the state calls non-trad, non-traditional. So that would be equivalent of like a male going into the allied health program.
Correct.
Or in this case, when you see the young ladies graduating from aviation or from manufacturing, they're going into those, you know, those STEM fields.
Absolutely.
So we're starting to see a little bit more of that,
absolutely.
Right?
And on that note, I want to talk about STEM Challenge Week, because Lindsay has lots to celebrate and to tell us about what she did during that week.
Yeah.
Perfect. So, nice segue there, Mrs. Pope.
Right. I'm learning.
Have you been on the...
I'm learning.
I'm going to go take a break.
Yeah, exactly.
So I teach second grade at Franklin Ave, and so... I was trained, like Chris mentioned, at WPI this past summer.
How long was that? And was it good training? I mean, did you enjoy it?
Yeah, so the training was 2 full days, you know. And
then we had a coach come in this fall.
Right,
to follow up. And we've been back to WPI, too, for conferences and networking and things like that. And really, we've been preparing just to start the first module, which I have just started in my classroom. So there's a lot of work that went into it. And so while we were sort of preparing for that to start, I, you know, heard of this STEM Week Challenge, and I know the whole district was really pushing everyone to get involved. And so we decided to do this STEM Week Challenge for K-2. And so
thank you for that.
Yeah, absolutely. It was so fun. But for K-2, it was all around food waste. Mm-hmm. And I think what every STEM Week Challenge, was it something about...
Was about waste? Ecology and...
Okay. There was a theme at every...
Recycling.
Yeah.
Right, so ours was food waste. And so we... Essentially, STEM Week Challenge was structured just like a module. So it was really kind of like teaching my first module, but in a week, you know?
Yeah.
So we learned all about food waste. We did experiments about how much waste we are creating in breakfast.
There's about 37,000 paper bags that are used at Franklin every year.
Right. So we really had to, once my students realized how much we were wasting during breakfast, we really had
to. How much are we wasting? I mean, is it significant?
Well, just in our classroom, from our little perspective, every student who gets breakfast has to get a paper bag and fill it up. And I think that's the way they count how many students are getting.
That's
correct.
Which is really
correct.
Important.
Correct.
Because that's a grant, too.
Yes, it
correct.
Is.
Yeah. And so we realized a few things. I mean, my classroom this day
was a mess. There was food everywhere, trash and milk and you name it. So I had it all sorted. We sorted it into piles and there were all these paper bags. And so what the students typically do is put all their trash
in the paper bag, right?
In the paper bag and then throw the whole paper bag away. And so they realized this the day of the experiment. And I didn't really know, you know, what was going to come of it, but we had to change that, you know?
Right.
And so we thought about what we could do, one small change we could make. And so now my students just recycle their paper bag. That
Perfect.
Was just one small change.
Right.
So that was one of the sort of experiments we did along the way. But our final challenge was, how can we preserve an apple? Like, we cut an apple in half, so it was a little bit exposed. And
yeah.
So they had to design something that would preserve the apple.
So it doesn't turn brown?
So that it didn't decompose.
Yeah. You never notice you cut an apple, you leave it out for, it turns brown.
Yeah, 10 minutes. 10 minutes.
Yeah, and actually what was funny is that same day we had apples for breakfast, but they were in a bag already cut up.
Already cut,
you know, so they put some type of
lemon juice.
So,
yeah.
We talked about that, too. So, you know, we got into groups, and the final problem they had to solve was to preserve an apple using only recycled materials.
So the whole school brought recycled materials.
Right, I sort of made the mistake of sending out an email to all staff.
Whoops.
I'm gathering recycled materials, and then I had a classroom full of trash.
Careful what you wish for, you know?
Right. So, you know, Chris knows me. I like things clean and organized, but that was not the way this week went. And it was great.
Getting out of your comfort zone.
Yeah, it was great. So they designed, and I didn't help them. They had used everything that they had learned along the way to design something. And I just was getting emails from Project Lead the Way and, you can submit one project,
you did that.
Classroom. And I thought, all right. So we voted, you know, they each designed something and we left the apple slice in their design for a whole day. And then we, you know, opened up the apple and we decided as a class that whoever's apple was the most, you know, white,
preserved,
most preserved, we would send it in. So I took some pictures of it. We had to kind of type up the
process. What did they do to keep their apple from going brown?
Okay, so I said to Chris, I wanted to help them, you know, because I didn't feel like even their design, the design who won, I felt like it could have been better, but...
But this all came from kids. This was generated. This is where we sometimes want to help too much as a teacher.
Right. So I really was hands off, you know.
Release the control.
Yeah. That's so what they did was they had an old cloth first around the apple. And so their thinking there was that it would kind of keep it moist and stop it from getting warm. Because it was October, so it was still had some warmer days. So it would kind of keep it cold. And so after that, I believe they had some parchment paper over it to keep the water out, because that was a factor too. And then they had bubble wrap around it, and then it was like kind of stuffed inside of an old like box, like an old Ziploc box. And so that piece, we got real world feedback afterwards, and so that was something that some people were asking them, why did you stuff it in the box? But so that was their design. So we took some pictures. We sent it in to the Mass STEM Hub. And the hardest thing was that we had to wait until, I think, November. So it was like a month away.
Right around Thanksgiving.
I let them know, you know, it's unlikely that we would win, but I think it would be really neat to get real world feedback, you know, like people asking questions and commenting on your...
Because they do. They have a panel review of all of the projects that are submitted. So cooks and chefs and scientists from different colleges and scientists that work in different industries review all these projects from second graders, first graders, kindergartners, and they actually comment. They ask questions of the students that the actual classroom can see. And I think that's part of that reflective nature and teaching kids that, if I let other people see what I do, I can even get better.
Going forward, we knew that there was a panel of all these different professionals from different industries, and even some college students were on the panel. And so we had to wait, and it was really painful for them to wait. And I just...
But?
Right. But then one day I got an email that I forwarded to probably all of you.
Yes.
Like, woo. So first I got an email that we were within the top three and to, you know, stay tuned.
Right.
And then the next day, And I didn't tell them because actually the email said not to tell
them
yet.
Don't tell them.
Right.
The whole social media piece there. Right. So then I had an email that we won first prize, and I was actually away at a math conference.
Right. Wow.
And so I was like, nobody tell anybody. I really want to be the ones to tell them. And so when I told them, actually, it was a team of girls.
Right.
Three students, and they were girls, and they were, I mean, everyone in the whole class was beyond excited.
Yes. Oh, I bet.
And the whole school we celebrated. Yeah.
Nice. I mean, we celebrated as a whole school, and just the prizes that they won. So they were sent a couple of books. Of course, we made a big deal about it and took pictures. And then the final big prize for first place is we get to go to Boston.
Yeah.
And we get to go to the TD Garden.
Yes.
And we get to, I think, have a tour of the kitchen and how they preserve food and things like
that. Oh, wow.
That. Right. And the Incredible. Connection there was that the chef from the TD Garden was in the module. So there were videos of him speaking to food preservation and things like that. So we get to go meet him.
How cool is that?
So that's to be grand.
And the kids are so excited to go to Boston.
And it was all them.
Yeah.
And I was thinking, oh, it's not the best design, but we'll get some feedback and it'll be great.
Well, because I saw the feedback too, right? I think that
came
forward.
Yep, it was in the
email. So what a great experience. Yep. All right, folks, it is 9:27. You're listening to Superintendent Spotlight on 89.5 FM or watching us on Channel 15. We'll be back in a few minutes.
One, two, three. Other night, dear, as I lay sleeping, I dreamed I held you in my arms. When I awoke, dear, I was mistaken. So I bowed my head and I cried. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away. Nothing else could come between. But now you've left me to love another. You have shattered all of my dreams. You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
Support for the community programming of WSKB is provided by the Dunkin' Donut Shops of Westfield and the Sardinia family. It's nice to know that even as the world changes, Dunkin' Coffee remains the same at 7 convenient locations throughout Westfield.
Support for community radio on WSKB provided by Westfield Electroplating. Employing over 140 skilled platers, painters, and technicians, Westfield Electroplating was founded in 1946 and was the first company in the country to achieve National Aerospace and Defense Contractor Program accreditation, proudly maintaining that status for over a decade. Westfield Electroplating provides over 50 quality finishes to meet your corrosion, cosmetic, or performance needs. On the web at www.westfieldplating.com or 413-568-3716. Westfield Electroplating, putting the finishing touches on technology.
Listen to me, Michael Buster McMahon, Mondays 8 to 10 a.m. to learn the stories behind your favorite songs. Or don't. I'm not the boss of you.
Community Radio.
89.5 WSKB.
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 and 89.5 FM WSKB Westfield.
Because of trading back.
Yeah. Hey, we're back live. Here we are on Superintendent Spotlight. So good morning. It's 9:31. It is 71 degrees in our wonderful space, but not outside, Chris. I think we're about 16 or 17 degrees, right?
Feels like 8.
Yeah, so it's a chilly one out there, but don't get used to it because by Friday, high of 49, Saturday, 60, Sunday, 60. Lots of rain, though, Saturday into Sunday.
Yes.
So hopefully a lot of the snow melts, as Pete was alluding earlier to some of the flooding that happens when you have this snow stuff. So that's our weather forecast. Today we have Franklin Avenue Elementary School. We were talking about STEM, and Lindsay was telling us about her project. So I just want to say congratulations to you and your students. I think that's important. What a wonderful accomplishment.
Yes, congratulations.
So congratulations.
Thank you.
Yeah. Where would you like to go next?
Well, I still want to stick with the STEM because it flows into other things that we're doing. Through our WeTuba network, we have
Westfield Education to Business Alliance, and that is our partnership with the Greater Westfield Chamber of Commerce.
Absolutely. Yep. We have an Adopt a Classroom program going on right now where both of our fourth grade classrooms are collaborating with the science department
at
Westfield State University.
Right.
And their main inquiry, their inquired question is the Westfield River healthy? So we have this river that has flowed for thousands and thousands and millions of years, and our kids live by it, but we don't always look at it as a living
and breathing. No, you take it for granted.
Of course not. Take it for granted.
Right. Yep. And so what I really wanted them to do was to understand what that river does for our economy, I mean, for our ecological system. And so they've paired together, and they've taken two field trips out there, first with just the class and some chaperone and teachers. Then Westfield State students and professors came. They... not our students, but the college students.
The Westfield State students.
Yeah, they weighed it out, and they got samples of the mud and all of the little insects that we find there. And they had to look, and based on the insects, this chart, all this different teaching, they took microscopes, and they had to determine, based on these microorganisms that they found, is the river healthy?
And
they all... We found that the river's pretty healthy.
That's pretty good.
There
was
some we didn't want to see in there, but for the most part, yeah. So this is
going
to be a collaborative effort looking at the changes that have gone over for the past million years. We're going to hopefully take a trip up to the watershed to see the differences and where the water comes from. And it's a wonderful hands-on learning experience.
What I like about this, and it gives me an opportunity just to shout out the Adopt a Classroom program.
Please.
And... okay, I may have been the one to come up with that, but I'll tell you, I was. But the reason I thought it was important is because I think our kids need real world. Okay, let me just hurt my arm here.
There's no shortage of accolades superintendent spotlight.
But
folks,
I think kids need an authentic learning experience, and I want to bring it back to Kelly Brown was talking about earlier, what your program is doing. And I think this is terrific because you know what, kids could read about a river in a book. And that's not going to stick with you, but they will always remember sifting through
the mud
at the Westfield River. So, and there's we're at 25 now. Adopt a classrooms across the district. There's one happening at every site, multiple at your site, at Westfield High School.
Yes,
the science department at the high school is working with Westfield State University science classes too.
Well,
so, I think it's a great opportunity. And if any other business or entity out there wants to collaborate with us, just let us know and we'll set something up.
Shout out to Jen Hasseltine, who really has
Hasselman,
Hasselman has
and Mary Keene.
Of course.
Let's not
Our own
forget.
Mary Keene. I'm thinking science department up there, but Mary Keene has been instrumental.
She's been great. I mean, I asked her if she could help facilitate some of this, and she just went and ran with it.
And that's what she does.
She does. She meets with the businesses, the teachers, connects them. I mean, her latest one she did is Peerless Precision is working with, speaking about women in STEM. You know, Kristen Colson,
she owns it, right?
Yeah,
she's a woman.
So they're working with the females and Matt Roth's sixth grade math class at Western Intermediate School. Yeah. They're going to go over there. I mean, that is stuff that kids will remember.
It will.
And it also, again, as we talked about women going into STEM, it certainly is opening doors to more opportunities.
Well, and just to the last initiative that we're doing in STEM is going to launch on Monday at 10 o'clock in the morning. Lisa Streichar is a retired science teacher from former North Middle High School, is actually starting a STEM program, a science oriented, for four kindergarten girls.
Nice.
So for a half hour every week, she's going to come in and they're going to read about science. They're going to do science experiments. And I'm hoping that she can foster that love of science and that curiosity.
Absolutely.
She's going to work on social skills, listening, speaking. It's a part of our mentoring program. So she's mentoring four girls in science.
Well, and I can say the three of us. I'm going to say we're the oldest in the group.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You're welcome. But, you know, when we were kids, I don't think, I know that the education system did not encourage females to go into these fields. That's not what society was like back then.
No.
And the reality is there are no limitations.
No.
We're trying to break some ground here and really, really let our young ladies know that this is a perfectly good field, your daughter included,
aerospace engineering.
Well, right. Coming
what I love about the Adopt a Classroom and with the focus with STEM is we're breaking down the misconception that a scientist is an older gentleman with glasses and a lab coat.
Right.
Now anybody, you can picture yourself as a scientist.
You're wearing waders when you're a scientist Westfield River.
That's cool.
Yeah.
Right.
And it can be anybody.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. What else?
So let's take the M in STEM for math.
We
just had, right before the holiday break, we had about 22 administrators and coaches from around Western Mass and Worcester area come in because they wanted us to showcase what we're doing with our ST math program.
You have something to do with that.
Well, honestly, all I did was steer it in the direction of Chris, and then Munger Hill and Franklin took it from there.
Yeah.
Right.
And I just actually, the best part about me was just getting out of the way.
Yeah.
To be honest, right? And letting it just happen.
Sure. But you need that spark. You need that spark. And that spark has turned
into financial investment.
Yeah. That always helps. But we're in the second year of our 3-year grant with ST Math. And what that means is we get a lot of professional development.
Right.
And where ST Math was a part of our resources for many, many years, teachers did not understand how to use it. They didn't understand all the components because we were never really trained.
Yeah.
So that training, we have a ST Math.
I'm there with Power School, just saying.
Yeah,
I'm still trying to figure out.
I can help you.
Okay, it does a lot though, but I don't know how to. Nice.
But, you know, we have an ST Math Champions in Reggie Rosario, our first grade teacher, and Lauren Martin's our third grade teacher, who are, you know, just learning about puzzle talks and all the different resources and how to present. This is a conceptual understanding of math. It's not the algorithms of the old days where you just carry the one and you just go through a process without understanding what numbers mean.
Right.
And so this is no language, just computer programs that give students pictures and computer games that they have to figure out percentages, or they have to figure out fractions, or they have to figure out, oh, if I take this ostrich, which has two legs, and this dog, which has four legs, and I have three dogs and four ostriches, how many legs do I have?
And ouch.
But they have to figure that out. It's not like they ask that in
But they're doing it on a program. Like when we were kids, we were doing that on paper, and I don't think the word problems were as ostrichy.
Right, but one of the things that Chris said was there is no language. There is no word. The student is challenged conceptually. They have to do the thinking. And what's great about ST Math is if you struggle, it's okay. It's productive struggle, and that's what it's
designed. And it helps you. The program helps you. Well, and it's using technology the kids are used to.
Right.
Again, which is, you know, we're going down to what they know.
Right.
And that's how you have to do it.
And the efficiency of it, because I don't want to say it's adaptive, but students are able to go further if they're there. And then there's also components that say, oh, teacher, this student's having a problem. They're called cones, correct?
Bubbles.
Right. Yep. If you want to speak a little bit to ST Math that you do in your classroom.
So one of the things I just thought of while you were talking about it was that ST Math really teaches students to make mistakes and watch what Gigi does. Right. When
that's the penguin.
Yeah. Well, I've learned the penguin. The students have taught me going through classes. We know the penguin. Yeah.
So I think when we first started with ST Math, like Chris said, it was just kind of used as a center. You know, we knew how to get students logged on, but we didn't know how to use it as a teaching tool. And so that's what our champions in our PD have really helped us to do. So now in our classrooms, teachers are using puzzle talks where you can pull up a puzzle on the projector or with a group of students on a laptop and sort of talk through the problem. You know, ask certain questions to guide students. Mm-hmm.
Get
through.
That deeper thinking.
Yep. And so that's something that I think I've really enjoyed. It follows our curriculum. It's really a virtual manipulative.
Right.
So another.
That's a really, really very, very strong description of it. I'm glad. Right. That's a great description of it.
I have a feeling Chris is going to steal that one.
Yeah.
Hold on. Jot that one down.
Yes. And it also promotes the language of collaboration in the puzzle talks because they're using the language of math and discussion because there are no words. They have to come up with the words. So that accountable talk piece at a table talking about a program.
Is it K to four?
Actually, no. It is K through eight, I think.
Well, we in our district right now, we're only using it K to four.
You're using it in all your grades, all your classrooms.
Oh, definitely. Okay. Definitely.
And I can say from a grandparent's standpoint, when your grandchild says, Graham, can I do ST math instead of Minecraft?
Yeah.
He just absolutely loves it.
Wow.
We
talked about
that's
that.
That's incredible.
Yeah.
Kelly, really does.
I can't even believe you're old enough to be a grandmother. So
I am one of the youngest. You just shocked me right now.
So, thank you though.
Yeah, he loves it.
I think that's how education has to be.
Yep.
Long gone are the days where here's a textbook, here's your worksheet.
Absolutely.
Sit in your you know, 5x5 rows. And those days are long gone because those aren't the kids that we have anymore.
No. Right.
So it's nice that we're adapting to that, those changes.
And I think we worry about just putting students in front of a screen.
Too much screen time.
What's really nice about ST Math is students really want to help each other.
Mm-hmm. Right.
And, you know, you talk to them about how to help, how to not give answers, not touch someone else's Chromebook and do what they're supposed to do, but sort of start asking questions.
Right.
Yeah. Or saying, can you go get a game mat or some blocks or a tool, a number line that
10 frames that, right. And so they use other manipulatives
on
the side.
So ST Math is not a time in my classroom anymore where it's quiet.
Right.
You know, I'll sort of group them together, and this came from Reggie helped me with this, grouping them together based on where they are in ST Math, the objective they're on. So they love helping each other.
I think one of the other things for ST Math, too, is it's a family involvement. I know in my grandson, because you have levels.
Right.
And you get so many stars.
Right.
And when he was going to make the 100%, my mom happened to be visiting, and we all had to sit on the couch
and watch
him do that last math problem so that we could all watch the penguin go nuts. Yes. You know? So, I mean, and I think it's really like more interactive for families because the kids can say, look what I'm doing, and this is what I'm doing.
And it's great for families because when mom and dad or grandma or grandpa don't know what's going on the screen, because you won't.
I don't care if it's kindergarten or first grade, then the student becomes empowered and becomes the teacher.
Last year you brought your students to the school committee meeting and they showed ST Math to the school committee members, and I just remember our former mayor was really getting a lot of guidance from the students.
And we all were, to be fair.
But it was pretty exciting. Hey, listen, we have to take another quick break.
I can't believe it.
The show's almost over. Can you believe it?
Almost.
It is 9:44, folks. You're listening to Superintendent Spotlight. We'll be back in a few minutes for our last segment.
Strong, and I'll be your friend. brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You just call brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on.
Support for Community Radio on WSKB is provided by Betts Plumbing and Heating Supply Company, an independent, family-owned wholesaler serving Westfield for over 50 years, specializing in plumbing, heating, and industrial piping supplies. On the web at BettsPlumbing.com or at 14 Coleman Avenue in Westfield.
Hi, it's Bob Plass, and I have Wow It's Tuesday every Tuesday, 6 to 8. Wow It's Tuesday.
Community Radio,
89.5 WSKB.
I did it!
Live from Studio 120 at Westfield Technical Academy, this is WCPC Channel 15 and 89.5 FM, WSKB Westfield.
And we're back with Superintendent Spotlight, broadcasting live from beautiful Studio 120 here in downtown Westfield. Our weekly, well, it's been a while, but it's usually our weekly segment where we kick off with some local and national sports. And we'll start with Westfield Technical Academy. Congratulations so far. The boys are off to a good start, 3-3 right now for Coach DeLude's squad, and beat... Their last two victories have come against rivals St. Mary's and Gateway.
That's never a bad thing.
And that's not a bad thing, including on the 7th, a couple of days ago, beating Gateway 52-26.
Yeah.
So we were excited about that. And by the way, speaking of excited in Westfield Tech basketball, our girls
won a game.
Defeated Pioneer Valley Christian 29-23 the other night. Folks, it's their first victory in nearly three seasons. Yeah. So congratulations to the girls.
Absolutely. Coach Nato, I think.
It reminds me of when we used to have a football team here.
Yeah,
when we actually won a football game.
Yeah.
It was like we won the Super Bowl.
Well,
you know,
it's the little things.
Right?
Yes, I do.
The little things, absolutely.
I do.
Switching over to Westfield High School, girls indoor track off to a good start. Right, Mrs. Tolpa?
It certainly is. I hear about it every day.
So the last meet that I've got a record of, though, was January 3rd, which was last Friday. Congratulations to Katie Bean for winning the 300 meters, qualifying for Western Mass with a time of 42.72. So congratulations. Boys and girls swimming, continuing their strong starts. We talked a little about congratulating Coach Lewis on his 300th victory right before the holidays, and it's continued afterwards. So congratulations to the boys and girls. Boys defeating Agawam 97-76 the other night. Girls defeating Agawam, get this, 124-58.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think we call that a whooping.
Yeah, we did. Holyoke, though, did knock us down a peg in boys basketball, 69-63 the other night, although Tony Torres led us with 19 points and Will Cameron had 12. But the boys are off to a strong start. And congratulations to our wrestling team, who doesn't get enough pub. They knocked around Ludlow the other night, 58-13. So congratulations, gentlemen.
Great.
Nice work. And as we head into this weekend, Zap, We've got some big time football games Saturday, Sunday, and Monday night. Because don't forget, Monday night is the college football championship, defending champion Clemson taking on LSU on ESPN at 8 o'clock. NFL over the weekend, though. Minnesota takes on San Francisco, 4:30 on
Saturday.
Shocker,
I have to be honest with you. I expected New Orleans.
I had a strong feeling about the Vikings all week for some reason.
You did.
I did.
Dalvin Cook.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Titans will take on Baltimore at 8:15 Saturday night.
Another shocking sort of... Yeah. Just as a Dolphins fan.
Who wants it more, man?
Yeah, well.
It was nice. Honestly, though, like, the Patriots losing is kind of a big deal.
No, it's not. They didn't have the team this year.
Well, no, but historically.
And they didn't have the will to win this year. Well, all I know it is.
Well, it is not. I'll tell you what happened, though, when that took place. Everybody knows Zapp and I are not Patriots fans.
No.
Right?
Yeah, I don't dislike them.
No.
Chris does.
I have a lot of respect for them, actually, except when they video the other team right before the game. It sounds like the Red Sox recently.
Oh, for Christ's sake.
Right, Pete? Yeah.
So, it wouldn't have been in sports if somebody wasn't cheating, right?
So, but the bottom line is, though, my phone started blowing up with Dolphin fans, Giants fans, Jet fans, like, celebrating because, wow, we're finally going to have a Super Bowl this year without the Patriots in it, which, if you think about it, doesn't happen that often.
Drew Brees is out, too.
That's right.
You know, I think most of the older quarterbacks are out. It's a young
Brady
young
and Brees are both.
But I just have to tell you, as a Dolphins fan, and I had the pleasure of actually going to see the Dolphins beat the Bengals, and I know
was a good game.
Yeah, it was a great game.
I saw that game.
They came back at the end. I mean,
the Bengals came back.
No, Miami looked good at the end of their season.
They did.
Well, they beat Ryan Fitzpatrick.
Yeah. And then they beat the Pats, and I'm just like, huh. I was kind of upset. Actually, didn't want to win those games because I wanted the better draft pick.
Yeah, but the Dolphins are still a top. They're the number 5 pick right now.
Yeah,
you got your eyes set on Tua. I hope I pronounce this right, Pete. Taliavua, right from Alabama.
Yeah, that's close.
It's close. Sunday the 12th, by the way, Houston taking on Kansas City, Seattle taking on Green Bay, and the Giants, New York football Giants, have just hired a brand new head coach. Congratulations to Joe Judge. His press conference today at 2 p.m. And folks,
teams guy from New England.
Yeah, special teams and wide receivers coach from the Patriots.
Yep.
Miami's head coach.
Is former Patriots.
Ryan Flores, former Patriots staff. And
Vrabel
Josh
is former.
Vrabel, Titans, and Josh McDaniels is interviewing.
Can I tell you what was particularly enjoyable? Seeing Vrabel use one of Belichick's particular trips
against
him.
That's what I said, yes.
And did you see Bill Belichick on the sideline kind of flipping out?
He used to use it a couple of weeks before.
Questioning the refs. What can you, you know?
Those three penalty rules,
Well, I knew the Patriots were going to win the game right before halftime. They didn't try for a 7-point score.
Yeah.
They didn't score in the second half.
That blew my mind that they didn't try. That's very unlike them. And I don't know. They just didn't have it in them this year. You could tell all season. They were just winning because they were pulling it out by the skin of their teeth.
Their defense was very impressive.
Right. And they're, you know, I hate to say this, but Antonio Brown, had they decided to keep him,
it would have been a lot
different
better.
Season.
I agree.
Yeah,
but sorry.
I think they made the right call.
I do too.
Absolutely. Yeah.
But you know, it left them without someone to.
If we want to teach our kids about sportsmanship,
that's right.
We need sportsmen on the field.
That's right, Chris.
Yeah. Now, is Josh McDaniel sticking around?
He's interviewing Friday for the Cleveland Browns job. I have a feeling.
There's not many jobs open.
Well, no. They're all filled but Cleveland.
Yeah.
So I have a feeling if he wants that job, it's his. And I have a feeling that he's going to, if he gets it,
he'll accept it. And then Brady will re-sign with the Patriots and then he'll renege on that one, too. Is that what you're going to say?
No. Yeah. Well, McDaniels turned the Colts down at the altar, basically.
Yeah, he basically did.
Right. But I get a feeling if he goes to Cleveland, he's going to take a bunch of New England staff
and Brady?
Front office staff with them. No, they've got.
I don't think he'll take Tom Brady. No. I think Tom Brady retires a Patriot.
I think Brady is Patriots or Chargers. You heard it here, folks.
Yeah.
I got a feeling.
That's a hot take out there.
Well,
right
he's got a house out there.
Right.
Right. So I could see because. Their quarterback, Philip Rivers, is also done.
I think his wife likes to live on the East Coast.
Well, we'll see what happens. I hope he stays with.
She has a lot of say in that.
Yes, she does.
Yes, she
does.
Yeah.
I have to go on record and say Tom Brady's going nowhere.
Yes. You think he's staying in New England?
Yep.
You're gonna have to pay him.
The only problem about that is the salary cap.
You're gonna
numbers
have to
don't
pay
quite
him.
Work out.
If you want him, you're talking 2 years and like $30 million to keep him.
Yep.
Or more.
Yep.
A year, a season, by the way. We're not talking
right
combined.
No, he wants
we're
big,
talking
he,
a season.
Well, he's got to go out with, I mean, this is the time he wants. He's got 2 years left. He said he wants to play to 45. He'll be 43 in August, so right. He can sign him to a 2-year contract for a good
It's going to be a fascinating offseason with him. Fascinating.
It is. I will say,
it'll keep
the
talk
of money,
shows going.
It will.
Yes.
The amount of money those people make is
if we
really,
could have a million at Franklin, just if one of them.
I was just going to say, the amount of money that they make.
We could do really make incredible. Miracles work.
Pete, would after Garrett Cole sign with the Yankees for 9 years and was it 400? I can't remember what it was.
An obscene amount of money?
Right. I think we broke
a
it down.
$1 million a start.
Is that right. What it was? We broke it down on the show. It was $1 million a start. It was something crazy like $11,000 a pitch.
It's an obscene amount of money.
That is an amazing amount of money.
Yep.
Mm. Obscene, I like better. That's obscene.
Yes,
mind-boggling.
Police and fire and
right.
Teachers, what we pay them.
Would you love $11,000 just a day? To work as a teacher.
We were saying, you
I'd
know,
like just put this.
Yeah. We in the wrong business.
We yeah.
Yeah, but we also forget though that athletes and sports in general, they're not. It's not the same. They're entertainers.
Right.
Like, oh yeah, I know.
We sit around our televisions on Sundays and then we're watching. It's like going to the movies.
Well, they also have to be in tremendous shape.
Oh, it's
they have
and
the
it's
work
a
they
year
have
round.
Not easy.
No,
and
no.
It's
not
a short lived career and it's a year round job. Yeah. And you know,
typically you're done at 40, no matter where you are, and then after that
35.
30, yeah.
35.
Yeah. No, running backs have a shorter lifespan unless
yep.
You're Adrian
yes, they
Peterson,
do.
Apparently.
Absolutely.
Who seems to be running forever. But listen, great sports conversation. I know we have a few things we have to
I want to run down some thank yous.
Okay.
I mean,
we've been
yes,
Franklin Ave all morning, and Kelly Brown is here from the Boys and Girls Club, too. What a great show. I can't believe the
great
show's
show.
Already over. I feel like we could talk for 2 more hours.
Absolutely.
But you have some things you wanted to wrap
up
with.
Yeah, there's some great things that have gone on at Franklin Avenue and are going on all year. But shout out to Andrea Allard, YMCA, for
yes,
giving us
thank
our
you.
Swim program for our second
absolutely.
And first graders, yeah. 30. Kids learn to
thank
swim.
You, Andrea.
First Congregational Church, they adopted us this year, gave us $1,000 budget to do whatever we needed to do offline, and we purchased shirts, we got graphics. I mean, we have mentors from First Congregational Church, and they're always bringing things to us. Darlene Biggs, big shout out to her. Movie nights, they're doing movie nights for Franklin and Abner every third Friday.
That's terrific.
Is a movie night, families are invited, and every first Saturday is drop and shop, where you can drop your kids off, go grocery shopping,
wow.
And have free babysitting. Big shout out to our PTO, Kaylee DeLuzio and Lisa Wengart. We had a quarter auction. We have a fourth grade field trip, first one. We're trying to get that in our an annual thing. A lot of other schools do it, so this
sure.
Is the goal of the PTO.
Good.
We have BMX biking coming, a Home Depot build. We have an anonymous donor who is bringing Cheryl Fay performances to us. She's a one-woman show about Amelia Earhart. That's what this team
wow.
Selected.
Oh, that's terrific.
Talk about women in STEM, right?
Mr. Parks, he owns Champion Taekwondo on Franklin Avenue.
Yes, yes.
I'm sorry, Franklin Street.
Franklin
he
Street.
Is one of our dads. He's coming in, taking our third graders for the month of January and February, and every Monday morning giving them a Taekwondo lesson. Fourth grade in March and April. So the kids are learning Taekwondo, how to break. I broke boards. It was awesome.
in my head.
Yeah. 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 Yeah,
video? Video of that? Because I want to see that.
You know what? We will do that.
I want a video.
I'll do it again. Second grade is going on a field trip to the Springfield Science Museum. Thank you to the Springfield Science Museum, Susan Dargy, for arranging it. Every second grade classroom in the city is going at some time this winter. And family dinner, Boys and Girls Club, another connection that we have. We host a family dinner every month for one of our grade level families. We have a lottery and 2 or 3 families come.
Wow.
I play pool with them. We use that rec room, ping pong with the kids,
wow.
Legos, and we serve it from 5:30 to 7, and it's just a way for us to get out of the building.
More
and
community building.
Yeah.
A lot of community relationships.
Absolutely. That's what we're all about.
And fabulous.
That's
Franklin
what we're
family.
About, but Westfield Public Schools.
Absolutely.
That's absolutely.
That's been our thing. Listen, folks, it's 10 o'clock already.
Wow.
Before we go, though, I just want to put Kelly on the spot for a second. I'd like to have you and Bill on so we can talk about the Boys and Girls
Club.
Oh,
yes.
Anytime. We'd love to come
okay.
in.
Great
let
idea.
Let us know all the great things that you folks are
thank
doing.
You.
We've had Andrea on last year.
Yes.
Bo came on and talked a little bit last year, but I think I really want you and Bill.
Yeah, that Bill will be
and Ashley.
You and Bill will be a great
and
show.
Ashley.
Yeah.
And then, Lindsay, thank you for all
thank
you,
Lindsay.
Do.
Thank
you
thank
for
you
being
for
on the show. I will send you all the video of this later so you can watch it and critique ourselves.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's what we do. No, but folks, I just want to thank you again. Say Happy New Year. It's
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year. Thank you to Franklin and the Boys and Girls Club for representing today, and I hope you have a great weekend already. I can't believe it. Tomorrow.
Enjoy the warm weather, folks, after we get through today.
Yeah. Absolutely.
All right, thanks.
Take care, folks.
Thank you.